Alright, good evening guys. Happy New Year 2024. Today is the 1st of January 2024, Monday, 7:28 p.m. And you know what, before I start anything else, let me wait. Yeah, great. 69.4. As you can tell, my weight, I think I measured it last time. I actually wanted to start like a habit of measuring my weight in all this, like my this daily vlog speech confidence practice series. And I've forgotten about it as well. I wanted to make a habit, so I'll probably start doing this every day on this video. Keep track of my watch, I mean my weight. So, all right, it's new year, new start. Well, not much of a start. Just, we're all just sticking to the same shit we've been doing for a while. And yeah, my throat is actually kind of dry. I had a long talk with two of my good friends and yeah, it's been I actually reconnected with one of my friends from way back. Very close friend of mine, and it's been a while, so yeah, New Year is actually a good time, not just with friends and with many of my relatives. I'm the type who just, I'm not very good at staying in touch with people in general. Like, I think I'm a decent friend. I'd like to believe I am. But when it comes to maintaining relationships and especially, you know, keeping in touch on a regular basis, I suck at it. I need to work on it, obviously. But yeah, I tend to disappear. Once I pick up something, I get into some hobby or I just get into some kind of sport or whatever. And then I just go hermit mode and then I disappear completely or some shit like that. So I'm very good at disappearing socially. So yeah, I need to control, like I have to pull myself back every once in a while. So I stick, make sure to keep in touch with my family, make sure to keep in touch with their friends on a regular basis. And so New Year, this New Year especially, as you guys can already tell, I've spoken about it a lot in my previous videos as well. So I've been going through a lot last 2 years. Actually, two and a half years back, I was in a bad place. And then I started this whole self-improvement journey and all this shit. And this YouTube channel is also a result of that. And so, like, after all that stuff, and last year was especially a great year, I've like got a lot of shit together and my fitness is as well doing well now. So I actually, like, this year, this new year, I really took the time to sort through all my contacts of like forever, everything. Like, I missed out on socially as well, especially socially. Like, that's where I still need to work on, because physically I'm at a good place now. I really sorted out my physique and stuff, and now I'm actually aiming higher for better performance, breaking my marathon, breaking my half marathon record, my PRs and stuff. So now I'm going for PRs rather than getting fit. So it's a huge improvement. And I did smash my 2023 goal of 2,300 kilometers, the first step of my 1 lakh kilometer goal. Lifetime goal. So yeah, so I went through all my contacts, and New Year, like, it's a good time to really, like, you know, break the ice with people and get in touch as well. So I did get in touch with lots of my relatives and people I have, like, yeah, people have been a jerk too, I suppose. So I did that, and I also happened to get in touch with a friend of mine, my roommate when I was in college. He's a very good friend of mine, and got in touch, had a real long talk, and yeah, I'm feeling great today. So So that's basically it for that. Also, for New Year, since it's this is New Year, this glass is bothering. So this New Year, I thought of resolution, and honestly, like, I probably have to think a bit. Let's see what I think of it. But like, New Year, since to commemorate this, might as well do it because it's a good opportunity to bind myself to another good habit. So this is one habit I want to, oh, actually two. I actually spoke with a friend as well. I was just speaking about it. So like every time I do a video, I should have started it first as well. So every time I do a video, I'll probably start like a stopwatch here. I just started it. And then I'll keep it running in the back here, right behind my camera. There. So like that. And then like while I'm talking a video, at least it would be visible right there. And just watching the time, it will keep me in track with how long I'm going with the video. And also it will help me condense my thoughts and be more on time with it and not go on tangents like I usually do. So it will help me keep the video short and concise and more to the point as well. Also, the other one is probably this, the weight, just now what I did. So every video, the moment I start the video, I'll start a stopwatch and also check my weight every day. So this weight thing, I spoke about putting it in every one of my video, I think about a few videos back, but I didn't do it. I missed it a few videos. And so, yeah, unless I am traveling in the somewhere place where I don't have a weight scale with me, and then it will be exceptions. But usually, and when there's a weight scale around me, I'll always try to measure it. So it keeps me in track with myself as well, because I do need to check my weight every once in a while. Not that I'm like, it's not good to get very conscious with your weight. Especially if you are gotten over the initial fitness phase, you know, where you're just getting into it. In my case, I've kind of gotten over the first initial phase. I'm now 1.5 year, almost 2 years into my consistent working out, running, works out and stuff, push pulls and score and stuff. So I'm over the whole getting into it. Now I'm in the performance, getting more better, getting more shredded stage. So my habits are set. So now like I can focus more on slowly cutting my weight, obviously for the abs and obviously for improving my performance, because mine is body weight workouts. And the more lighter I get and the more lean muscle I build, the stronger my push-ups, pull-ups will be. So that's like, and even running will benefit a lot from my reduced weight. So that's what I'm doing now. Like, I'm not exactly cutting aggressively. I'm just keeping it so that like I slowly cut it over time. As I gain more lean muscle, I also keep cutting and like improving my PRs in all everything I'm working on. So yeah, so that's why I'm not obsessed with my weight anymore. But it's still just checking it every day still keeps me in check with my, especially with my snacking, especially around this season, New Year, Christmas, holiday season, I tend to snack. And well, with social gatherings and stuff, I am vulnerable to it as well. So yeah, checking the weight helps. Also, it might be a good way of reminding you guys as the viewers as well, any of you who are following me at this point, to also keep track of your own weight. If you have a weight scale in your house, maybe check it. Don't get obsessed over it. Don't beat yourself up over it because of it, but it could be a good way to keep yourself, like as in like with expenditure as well. I had that experience with money as well, with finances. Like the more, it's good to check your, you know, your account statement or whatever, your transaction history every once in a while, maybe at least once a week, so that you just looking, going through your list, okay, this is where I spend, this is where I could have saved. I didn't need to buy this, you know, I didn't need to get this dinner or whatever. And then just going through it, even though you don't do anything else with it, just you being aware of it keeps you in check. So with the weight as well, just me being aware of it doesn't mean I have to get obsessed with it and, you know, get into some weirdness, you know, disorder, like some weight disorder, something, psychological issue. Nothing extreme like that, but like just keeping in check, knowing my current weight and how much I'm losing or gaining over time. It does fluctuate every day, the water level and stuff, the hydration levels. But just me staying in touch with what, where I'm, if I'm gaining or losing, helps me to avoid, suppose if I'm gaining a bit, oh shit, maybe I shouldn't snack today. And so that's how, like, it does keep me in check. So just for keeping in check, so that would be it. So I guess today's video title might be just two new habits. First is the every time I make a video, I start a stopwatch there to keep me in check of the time, keep my video and words concise. Helps me with my the skill I'm developing as well of this like random on the fly talking skill. And at the same time, it also the weight one, just to keep me in check physically. So those two new habits, for the year 2024. Like resolution wise, I need to think that I haven't sorted out my thoughts. Okay, I probably need to make the table, write down stuff, like things I'm need to work on areas of my life. I need to work on areas of my life. I need to like manage and stuff. And then areas of my life I'm already doing good at. And depending on which I'm not having issues, which I'm having issues with, I'll probably find something, a good, rather than a goal, probably a good habit that can help me deal with one of the issues of that. So let's see what resolution I can come up with, but I might never come up with it, honestly. Because, let's see. But like just to commemorate today, two new habits, the stopwatch and the weight check every day, at least on this video. So this series, speech confidence practice series, and this daily vlog thing. So that's it. I hope you guys are doing well. Hope your family, friends are doing well. Check up on them. Take this opportunity to reconnect with people, with your families, with people you have ghosted for, I don't know, years or maybe even decades. It's a good time. Everyone is in the mood for reconnecting. So like, take this moment to break the ice. Or I don't know, wherever you are with your relationships. Like, so yeah, that's it. And maybe make a resolution for yourself. Don't pick anything fancy, just pick something small you can do, as Jordan says it and many others. Like, start with something small, pick whatever you can. Maybe just get into the habit of brushing at the same time, or waking up early around the same time, or going to bed around the same time. I'm still working on my going to bed around the same time. It's still hard for me, but now I'm kind of boiled down to 8:30 p.m. and waking up around 4:30. So I'm still working on it, but I've kind of gone down from 4:30 to like 5 now in the last few days with the New Year and Christmas celebrations and family and, you know, all these parties and stuff. But probably tomorrow I'll get back right back to it before 4:30. I might actually increase it further to 3:30 to 4 a.m. Yeah, I probably should. So, and because I need to fit my Japanese lesson, and I want to start on the music as well. I've been procrastinating on it for a while, so I probably would start on it as well. So let's see, maybe not tomorrow, but by day after tomorrow, like, I'll sort it out tomorrow in the afternoon. Probably sometime I'll get down, take out my like diary and just start writing down and how to reach. I'll probably do some adjustment with my schedule and then put a music class in as well. Let's see how that fits in, because I'll need to squeeze it in very tight. Already occupied with lots of stuff now. So, all right. I'll catch you guys tomorrow. For accountability, today I'm missing my Japanese lesson. Today is Monday. I'm supposed to do Japanese lesson on weekdays, but today I'm not because it's New Year. This is an excuse, but that's how it is. So definitely tomorrow though. All right. Good night. I'll catch you guys tomorrow.